Hey guys, it's your boy Crippers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Fine Art career mode where last time I left off. It happened again. I drew with another title rival in December in a career mode in FIFA 16. Again. The run continued. I don't know why this happens. Anyway. Not focusing on that. It's big first game into his episode because it's the first game in the Dutch Cup. As you can see, I've put together a second team. I couldn't put together a full second team. As you can see, the left center back. He is actually a left back. Yeah. I only have three center backs, which is something I'm going to have to look at in general. If I'm going to use the second team on a more regular basis. But we'll see how the team does. There's a lot of youngsters in the team. It was pointed out to me by my friend that the average age is about 21 and a half. Even though there's like the majority of the players are actually 20 or younger. So, interesting. Interesting math there, ladies and gentlemen. Not that it has anything to do with the team. I'm just hopeful that they can get the job done. Now, a lot of you are going to be wondering why I'm putting out a second team, even considering Feyenoord won the cup in real life.
Football magazines.
Well, if you are, you might be new to this channel, because I do this in every career mode. It doesn't matter if the team won the cup in real life. I do want to get the second string players out for, out on the pitch, see what they can do. Maybe one of them can
real good contest between these
impress
two
me and put their name in the headlines.
Look at the manager at what they need in the transfer market.
So we'll see. He were central defender is
what's required, and here he is making his goalkeeper comes out with a punch.
One name you're going to recognize instantly is Ruben, because of course he's made a few substitution appearances this season. Tornstra, who I think made a substitution appearance in the last episode.
Giving the ball away now.
Nomel. Jefferson. Tornstra.
Opportunity now.
Oh, good block. Ruben denied by a great save slash defender block. Oh, combination of both. I thought it was one or the other. It was both. Huh. Fancy that. Fancy that. I can't make the pass, but I win it back. Come on, give me an option. Tornstra. Goes for it. Off the bar. Tapina. I tried to play into a player in a much better position in for an easy tap-in, but he miscontrols it.
Impairs vision, and if it gathers on the ball as well, of course, that's when the ref has to have a look at it. Christensen. Ebersilio.
See, no worries.
Good play for the referee here. Playing the advantage.
He's for the second team. They're looking solid. They haven't gotten the goal yet, but
it's turned over.
I feel like it's coming. I feel like
play is lost, and they now got to get back.
Yeah.
Try and make sure they don't concede themselves.
Maybe here, Gufferson. Fouled.
Free kick given by the referee.
Just outside the box. The defending team might be in trouble. Great place to put the ball into the head of someone. Really tall in the box. I don't know. I didn't look at the heights of the players, but I'm gonna. I can't actually.
Well, he has cleared the danger.
I just hit it in hope, and of course.
Here's the chance to get in the cross.
Spill. Of course, Spill. Keeps it in. Gerson, what is that? Instead of hitting a goal, he kind of like return crossed it. Which was weird.
Epicilio. Well, they've got a corner out of the
well, hey, a defensive error leads to another corner.
Alan, your view on the attempt at goal? Well, I think that crossbar's still shaking after the ferocity of that shot from miles out.
Let's try this again, Gerson.
And he's up for
in. Oh! Yes! Oh! Again! Pretty much cleared off the line. And on that occasion. Ruben, can he get there? He can't. So far, I'm having no problem. I'm not having any regrets about playing the second string team, and they're playing brilliant. It went another corner. Can I get the breakthrough before the half is over? Nope, not like that anyway. Let's see if the keeper's kick out is the last of the game. Not yet.
Cross it.
Oops, in.
Great work.
Ah. This time his kick out might be the last of the half. No? No, the header is the last. Touch of the ball before the half.
But we're halfway through it.
What? I'm feeling confident. I'm not worried. Because the goal will come. The goal is going to come.
Two teams vying for a place in the last eight.
Here we go. Torstar.
Yeah, really enjoyed this one, and I think there might be a few goals to come in the second half.
The defense is under. Cardonk. Ooh. Wins another corner. Is that four? It might be four.
Driven goalwards. Five goalwards. Well, no scraps for the attackers to feed on from the goalkeeper that time. Hung on to the ball well.
My center back. Back. My apparently only backup center back. Is
well, they're in a good position here.
Not been clinical today. Turns to that. Can't get his cross in, but he's going to collect the ball.
As they build this attack.
Cardonk. Jefferson. Tapia. Ooh, another block leads to another corner. Let's try something different. Ah. Coversville. Oops, in. Going for Ruben. Ruben is beaten there by the keeper.
Want to keep the opposition penned back this
we have a throw. Take a quick.
Just spotted the ball up on their play.
Cardonk. Nalome.
And the away team want to make a change. And there is some backup for him in this position. Put it in well. Cross is blocked here.
Cardonk.
Lovely one-touch football.
Gufferson.
Well, this goalkeeper looks absolutely determined to keep this clean sheet of his. What a save. It's a real tussle between the two of them. Try and get the ball. Zaibalov. 20 minutes. Oh. Possibly a booking this.
Referee felt like he was going to call it back for the foul, and he did.
That will help ease the pressure. Verdonk.
Tapia. Long. Bass is offside. If you're wondering why I'm calling him Bass, I can't pronounce his name. So I'm just calling him Bass. Gofferson. Great opportunity. Hey, go for it. No! Are you kidding me?
Where the keeper will not be beaten. He's filling that goal today.
Tapia. Bass. It's out for a throw. 10 minutes to get the goal. Starting to get a little frustrating now. You know, just a little. Gofferson, are you freaking kidding me? Nalom. It's in. There we go. 1-0. Can't tell who scored it. I can't see his name.
And the keeper's just grasping at thin air. What a header to find the top right.
Oh, it was Gofferson. After his shot was saved, the cross comes back in, and he is the one to knock it home. There we go. I told you I felt the goal was coming. See? Trust in your instincts, ladies and gentlemen.
Just one goal.
And sometimes they will lead you to victory. Jefferson might get a second. Ruben does add a second. And we are going through two late goals.
Nobody else has had a chance to react.
Was after her whole game of dominance.
Place it into that bottom left. Well, I want to see this again, this goal.
The young American striker slides it home. And that wraps up my progression in the Dutch Cup.
Restarting at 2-0.
Justifies this second team playing again this season, and probably when the next round fixture comes up.
Well, I can't recall, Alan, the goalkeeper actually touching the ball in this game. He's been a bystander.
Pretty sure that was the first touch of the game for my backup goalkeeper. How little he had to do all game. The fact that they only got into my box like twice, and that was at the right at the end of the game. It was kind of sad.
Is all that matters, and they have won.
But the dominance pays off. Han is clapping like he freaking pulled off a million saves. You know, he touched the ball once and didn't do anything else throughout the whole game. Yeah, that's no real surprise. Gofferson gets a 9.7 man of the match, goal and an assist, of course. And he was clinical. 5 of 6 shots he had were on target. Very good game for Gofferson. And he definitely has grabbed my attention. That is exactly what I wanted one of my players to do. And they delivered. And that is exactly the response I wanted, especially after the last game. Well, Kout is retiring, so no one can really sign him up. At least I think he's retiring. Yeah, no actions for a retiring player. So, seven league goals and five assists. Not bad for Dirk Out. No. Not his best season. Not by a mile. You know. 16 games in good performances. See, this is the problem you have when a player plays well. Now, Gufferson is asking to play in the next match, and realistically, I can't really deny him. I will bring him on as a second half substitute. I can't in good... good conscience... let him play with that energy, because he'll get tired out quickly and he'll be a burden until I sub him off, and I really don't like to use early substitutions unless it's absolutely necessary, i.e. a gap in the defense like a red card or for an injury. Unless it's absolutely necessary. I'm not one of those kind of guys who make early substitutions. Like, the earliest I'll make a substitution normally is probably halftime if I feel like it's necessary. I guess every manager is different. Some managers, there are managers out there who will make first half substitutions if they feel it's not going well.
Corner coming up. Dirk Out!
Done off to a pretty fiery start or in this match. Already has that's
good piece of tackling
there. He down a corner knocked back out.
We could be in.
Stendera is offside. I figured he was. I was like, wait, that's way too easy.
He has cleared it well. It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball. Got it back again.
Oh, Hannah. Kramer. What a ball to Kramer. Can he finish it? Great save from the opposition keeper. But it's come to Kaut, who's already gotten a few assists as we saw earlier. Ohana. Vidrich. Stendera. Goes for a goal. Easy. He take for the keeper. Probably should have passed that instead of shooing it. Them's the breaks. Dujanovic. Kaut. Go on, Dirk.
It's another very good save. And it didn't get away from him, the ball either.
The defender got in the way of my setup pass. Ohana. That's a foul. Really? So it's just okay for him to take my player.
And it comes quickly with a throw.
There's clean out. Wow. Bias much? Stendera might make it irrelevant, and it is irrelevant. Mark Stendera makes it 1-0. Oh. When I need someone to step up this season, it's been
coming in from the right.
And the man, and he signed Mark Stendera. See, that's my genius. Like, I guarantee you, unless you were a fan of the a German club. I don't even remember what German club I signed him from. All I know is Stenda is a beast. And my purchase was on the money and very much worth the money. Bidzovic.
Elliot. He's crossed it well.
Kramer into the goalkeeper's header is not really gonna trouble the keeper. Well, it didn't trouble the keeper. Out wide, no one, because it completely went over Kaut's head.
Here comes the cross.
That wasn't the best clearance. Hell yeah.
It's an exhibition here. Shots on here. Didn't hit it cleanly at all.
Wider than the mark. Hurt bad wall. I'm Burke. Well, the Kaut. Still damage. Get a cross in. In. Oh. Can Kongolo make it? He can't. He'll take the throw though. Ohana. Stojanovic!
Useful block in
wins the corner. Probably would have had a badge. Not concerned. I think it was in the air when I struck it. Elia!
Catch by the keeper.
Thought the deflection might take it away from the keeper, but it didn't.
Well, the referee has signaled for
1-0 halftime. Good, but not safe. As I found out in the last episode. Again, I know. No! Lead is safe. Any Croatians will say, hey, they know exactly what I'm talking about. Not sure how, but they threw a almost certain in and drew with the Czech Republic. I'm still trying to figure out how the hell that happened.
Good place to win the ball back there because the pressure was starting to mount and the interception was timely to say the least.
Great steal by Kaut. Oot. Trying to get his way into the box. Stendera goes for the fancy. Why didn't he turn around and take a proper shot? Why did he go for the fancy?
The keeper that came forward and did the business.
Stendera. Oh yeah.
And there is some backup for him in this position.
Chance to cross it.
Penalty. Thank you. That was an easy penalty to win.
It's a yellow card.
And a yellow card for... I was going to say, Pinkovision, but that's not his name. That's the team sponsor. It's a good thing I noticed the name on the other player's jerseys before I say. And Dirk Kaut doubles my lead. He'd on the 61st minute
the second there because it looked like it might miss.
For his 8th of the season.
Just widen the margin here to 2-0.
The brilliant signing and the former Liverpool man. You can trust what you know.
Asamoah.
And what you don't. Because I hadn't got a clue about that before I signed him to say. No one will forget his name after this career.
Ball's gone again.
For damn sure.
Elia.
I think I've made
not a good challenge by the defender.
Absolute sure of that.
Race to try and hit it now.
Elia score. Makes it 3. Enid. Hope it's made almost safe, you know. Kind of, you know, Sam, relatively safe from dropping points, but I'm not gonna take my foot off the pedal just yet, because I don't want to say I have something I don't have. I don't have the win until the final whistle goes.
Well, I've lost the ball.
Crap, spilled my water.
I see a substitute coming on for the away team here. It's a real tussle between the two of them to try and get the ball.
Vahana. I think now would be a good time for a substitution, which means Gufson will make his
decent attacking play. Good skill with the ball to beat
league
man.
Appearance. He asked for and earned.
There's going to be a substitution. It's for the away team. Andrew Driver. Able to make a good interception.
Kramer. Vahana, can he do something before he goes off? Oh!
Past the keeper, but just past the post. As far as central midfield players,
oh, they're making a substitution as well.
Recently, Alan, this is right up there, isn't it?
Oh, a double substitution.
Now.
Well, I thought he was going to be in for a really tough battle today against this side, but
are I'm going mad, or they just brought on someone called Cass Peters?
Coming off rightfully to plenty of applause,
which is odd. See, did they bring on
some league leaders?
Yeah, they are.
See, they did. Oh my God! What are the freaking odds?
Another shot. Well, that's a good block.
Jefferson.
Possibilities here from the cross.
Ball to Kaut. Ooh. No assist this time.
Had a bit of time and space. Good position.
Kaut couldn't convert the chance. Didn't even win a corner.
And it's going to be a minimum of 3 minutes to be played of added time.
Elia.
Hero Elia.
It's in. Stender. How did he miss that?
Just off target.
Yeah, unlucky because he got some power behind the ball, just not the direction.
What a good ball into the middle.
Hang on, that was Kramer. Missed that.
You can see why it's an absolute sitter.
Kind of makes sense. Kramer has been hot and cold this season. But luckily, the rest of the team made up for him having a cold game by having a very, very good game from the rest of the team. It looks like Vahana got the highest rating. He did. Man of the match went to Vahana. Maybe I should have taken out Vidrjic, because he played 6.3. Ah, that would be why Vahana got man of the match. 2 assists. He assisted both goals. He assisted 2 of the goals. Of course, Elia won the penalty. Which should technically count as an assist. Since. You know what? Never mind. I'll count it as an assist, even if the game won't. Which it won't. No problem. And who knows? Maybe you'll play more throughout the season. I wouldn't rule it out. I would not rule it out. Let's see what is coming up in January. No cup match. It's not until February. Maybe he'll make substitution appearances in one of the four January matches. Nice break until then. Fancy. So yeah, looks like I will go into January. And who knows, maybe by the time you guys see next episode, I will sign some new players, you know? Work my managerial scouting genius. Yes, and find another great player. I think a center back is definitely necessary if I'm gonna field a second team again this season, which I definitely will. Well, yes, their goals were late, but the key point is that they got them and they got the win. So, Kramer's gone down with an injury. He's going to be fine for the next game, because there's not a game in the next 7 days, but, huh, that's interesting. Yeah, I'm not going to even dignify that transfer offer. How did they send a transfer offer in the first day? Well, Kramer will be fine. There's not a game in 7 days, so. Well, the next video will be up in the next 7 days. It'll be up Tuesday. Wait. Yeah, today's Saturday. I was trying to remember what day of the week it was. That's the end of the episode. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe for more. Or content very, very soon. And yeah. Until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day.